Hey friends, this is Brandon here with Android Police, and Android Pie has been released for Pixel devices and other devices that support Treble. But maybe you don't have a Pixel device, or maybe you plan on getting a Pixel 3 or 3 XL soon and you want to know what to expect. Let's go over 10 features or changes in Android Pie and how to bring back that system UI tuner that seems to be missing. Number 1. Gesture navigation. So keep in mind that gesture navigation is not enabled by default on Android Pie, but the Pixel 3 and 3 XL are rumored to come with it already enabled. If you do want to enable it on a device that you have now, just go to Settings, System, Gestures, and then select Swipe Up on Home button. So what is it actually like using gestures? You can still simply tap on the pill at the bottom to go home. You can swipe on it once to go to the app overview, or swipe up again to go to the app drawer. You can also do a long swipe up once to go straight to the app drawer. Now let's see what's different in the app overview screen. When you go to it, you can swipe between apps. You can swipe up to close them, copy and paste text from the cards, and click the icon to access split screen features. I'm not a big fan of this being hidden in the icon. With the pill, you can hold down and scroll to the left or right to move between apps, or you can quickly switch between the last app that you used by just swiping right real quick. You can still hold down on the pill to access the Google Assistant, and when you're not on the home screen, a persisting back button is present. So for those of you who are used to the traditional triangle, circle, square layout, you may think that this is a bad change, and honestly, I used to be in the same camp. But since I've used gestures for the past few months, going back to the old layout actually feels way more clumsy than I ever remember it being. And according to the user interface team that performs studies, the average consumer picked up on gestures quite easily. And since we're already looking at the gestures, let's look at number 2, manual rotation. If you already have your orientation lock turned on, there's this amazing new feature that pops up when you rotate your phone into landscape mode. You can simply touch the icon that pops up and manually choose to rotate your screen so it isn't randomly flopping around. This is so good, especially if you're like reading your phone in your bed or something. Now let's look at number 3, design changes. The icons and fonts look different all around. When you look at the drop-down menu, a lot has changed here. The quick toggles are simply on and off, with additional settings if you hold down on the icon. Along with that is an option for a kind of dark mode that makes your app drawer and your quick toggles dark gray. One thing to note though is that your notifications and settings are still white though. Number 4, addressing notifications and rogue apps. You will now see notifications of apps that are running in the background so you can be aware of what's happening on your phone. And with that information, you're able to stop the app. Number 5, the ability to screenshot and edit your screenshots. Screenshots are the same, you still hold the down button and the power button simultaneously, but when you get a little notification of your screenshot, there's an option to edit. When you go to edit it, you can see that you can crop it, but you can also highlight things and draw on it. This is super helpful, and hopefully they get some features that Samsung has where you can combine screenshots. Number 6, volume button changes. So a lot of people have been frustrated about the volume rocker in the past, but in Android Pie, it defaults to your media volume. There's a quick toggle at the top to change between vibrate or notifications off, and an icon to go to your sound settings to get more granular settings. I'm actually a really big fan of this. Number 7, the clock and the notifications have moved sides to accommodate notches. Yep. Instead of the clock being on the right hand side, you'll see it on the left. And as you've known this past year, there's been tons of phones with notches, so this is to accommodate that. You can actually see the different notches that Android Pie supports by going into the settings. Number 8, things are powered by more AI. One cool feature that I love is app actions. As you continue to use your phone, there are different actions that show up in your app drawer. Sometimes it's simply going to a specific area in your app or performing a specific task. And then you'll also see that there's suggested apps that pop up in the app drawer. It understands your most used apps and bases its selection on how, when, and where you use it the most. There's also adaptive brightness. It learns how you change the brightness based upon the environment and learns to auto-adjust it for you. So there's one thing that's changed in here that some people are concerned about. They said that the screen brightness is not as bright as before. But keep in mind that Google changed the way the slider works from a linear scale to a logarithmic scale. That means its brightness between 0 and 100% is more consistent across rather than a huge jump later on. There's probably some AI reason for that, I don't know. And then adaptive battery. This prioritizes the battery so it goes to the apps you use the most in order to extend your battery life. And number 9, one of my favorites, digital well-being. Digital well-being is a really neat feature found in Android Pi that helps you better understand how you use your phone and gives you the tools to help you use your phone in a more healthy way. On the main page, you can see how much time you've used on your phone and what the distribution of time is between apps. You can see how many times you've unlocked your phone, as well as how many times you've opened a specific app. You can see how many notifications you received, and then how many times a specific app has created a notification. This is also a convenient place to control all your notification settings. There's also an area where you can set a time limit for how long you use each app. Ironically, you'll receive notifications when you're reaching your limit, and then once you reach your limit, the icon will turn black and white and then notify you that you've reached that limit. And then along the lines of that, there's the wind down feature, which can allow you to automatically turn on Do Not Disturb and turn your entire screen grayscale so you're less likely to use it. So I've been using this for about a month so far, and it's actually really beneficial. I've been able to be more productive and go to sleep a bit easier. Instead of swiping through my phone when I'm laying in bed, I'm just not as motivated to use it because it's in grayscale, and then I just go to bed. It legitimately does help with taking care of your own digital well-being. And then let's talk about number 10, the System UI Tuner. So for those of you who are more savvy, you may know about the System UI Tuner. It has allowed you to control what icons show up in your notification shade, display your battery percentage, and add seconds to your clock. But it seems to be missing, right? Well, there's a solution to that. While it's hidden from accessing easily within the OS, you can download Nova Launcher. When you use Nova Launcher, you just add a widget, then go to Nova Action, and then choose System UI Tuner, and then make your changes here. Super simple, no rooting. So what do you think about Android Pi? For those of you who have already used it for a while, leave some comments down below and let me know what you think. For those of you who have not used it so far, what are you most looking forward to? If you've enjoyed this video, please like it and share it and subscribe. And if you want to check out more videos from me, go ahead and click the icon of me in the middle. Thanks as always for watching Android Police. Until next time.